The Martinsville Bulldog Boosters. Join the Martinsville Bulldog Boosters and be a part of all the athletic programs at Martinsville High School. Meetings are held on Mondays at Arts and Deli at 43rd East Church Street in Martinsville, in Uptown Martinsville, during the evenings. Enjoy great food and fellowship with Bulldogs fans and coaches, and then starting at 6 o'clock, but the meetings themselves start at 7. Annual membership dues are only $5. For more information, contact Tim Bird at 638-2727 or email at birds85@comcast.net.
Okay, welcome everybody to the nice ball game here at the Doghouse. Big, big Piedmont District matchup between the Warriors of Magna Vista and the Martinsville Bulldogs. This game is being played on Friday night, January the 20th. Bulldogs come into this contest with a 7-9 record, a 2-1 record overall in the Piedmont District, while the Warriors come in with a 10-7 record and a 3-0. And now it's time for the national anthem.
To present our national anthem, members of the Martinsville High School Concert Choir, led by Michelle Meyer.
All right, and now for your starting lineups.
First
of all, for the Magna Vista Warriors, their starting five, Darius Waller, JaVale Kidd, Keon Mabin, John Terrio Harrison, and Latrell Wells. Magna Vista comes into tonight's game with a 10-7 overall record. They are 3-0 in the Piedmont District. The Bulldogs come into the contest with a 7-9 record. They're 2-1, so this is a big ball game for both clubs. Magna Vista was victorious in the JV game. The JV's Warriors winning a very close, hard-fought ball game, 41-37. And the JV coaches, Doug Hankins and his son, Cricket Hankins, did an outstanding job. They had to give up three of their starters to the varsity because of the injuries that the varsity has sustained throughout this season. Up from the JVs, we have sophomores Jacques Clark, Cameron Turner, and Darius Dillard, all sophomores that have been brought up. Starters for the Bulldogs are going to be Trey Harrison, Ishmael Harrison, Damian Patterson, Jalen Dillard, and Paris Jamison. And it's good to see Damian Patterson back in the lineup, and we're hoping that he'll be able to play most of the ball game. As you probably know, he's been playing with a bad ankle. Also, we know we've lost Akeem Moorhead, one of our starters and probably an all-district guard, to a broken leg a couple of weeks ago. So he's out for the season, but his leg is mended and he's doing well. The Warriors are coached by Kevin Johnson, also assisted by Corey Reynolds, Mervin Brown, and Clay Henson. The JV team for Magna Vista is coached by Donnie Morris and Matthew Bram. The Bulldogs are coached by head coach Kelvin Jackson, assisted by Maquel Gravely, Larry Harrison, Javon Williamson, and statistician is Tony Jeter. This is going to be a ball game that's going to feature a lot of quickness on both sides. The advantage that Magna Vista has is in the height area. They're quick, and they've got a lot of the 6'1", 6'2", and then a couple of 6'6 kids that will come off the bench. You got Bronte Dickerson, who just became eligible, and Gabe Hagwood, and both of those guys will play a lot tonight, and they're both in the 6'6" height range. So this is going to be a real tough situation for the Bulldogs as far as the height advantage. They're going to have to do a good job of blocking Magna Vista off the boards. Otherwise, it's going to be a long night for the Bulldogs. Bulldogs control the tip. Looks like the Warriors in a 1-3-1 zone. Bulldogs set up their offense. Ball's in the corner. They're going to trap it. Nice pass. Blocked by the Warriors. Out of bounds. Off the Warriors. So it'll be Bulldog basketball. Good defense there by the Warriors blocking. You're going to see a lot of balls probably get blocked tonight because they got some guys that can really leap. Bulldogs working against the zone. They're going to double the ball when it gets in the corner. Got a man open at the top. Shots up a little strong. Bulldogs come away with the rebound. Number 14 with a shot is good. Three-pointer, number 14, Damian Patterson. Bulldogs in a little zone press of their own. They'll probably try to trap the ball when it gets to midcourt. Now they're back in a man-to-man. Going to be a physical ball game. I'm going to tell you right now, this is going to be a physical game. Ball's out of bounds, almost out of bounds. Bulldogs save it. Here come the Bulldogs in the front court. Cross court pass, shots up, good. Number 30 for the Bulldogs. Jalen Dillard, 5-0 Bulldogs. Bulldogs in a press. Looks like they're going man-to-man, 55. They're in their man-to-man defense. Ball's almost lost. Pass inside. Little contact, no call. Shots up by number 42. He's fouled. Latrell Wells will go to the line for the Warriors. He was fouled in the act of shooting, so he'll shoot two. Foul was on number 10, Ishmael Harrison. 6:17 to go in the first quarter. Score, Bulldogs 5, Warriors 0. For shots up, no good. The Warriors and the Bulldogs met earlier this year, and it was a pretty close ball game. So playing here at the Doghouse, that game I think was played at Magna Vista Christmas tournament. Shots up and good, 5-1 Bulldogs. Warriors are still looking to press. They're going to double the ball when it gets across half court. Bulldogs do a good job of breaking pass. Shots up, no good. Rebounded by Paris Jameson. He puts it up, no good. Rebounds up and in. Number 10, Ishmael Harrison with the stick back. Bulldogs steal the ball. They'll come back and set up their offense. 7-1 Bulldogs. Bulldogs would like to get off to a quick start and get a lead. Bulldogs need to pass it. There's an open three. Shot seven, good. Number 10. Ishmael Harrison with a three. 10-1 Bulldogs. 5 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the first quarter, and the Warriors call timeout. Reminder that this game is being played on Friday night, the 20th of January. The upcoming events, some of the upcoming events tomorrow, the 21st, the wrestling team will be at Brookville for a wrestling match. The Bulldog Boosters will meet Monday the 23rd at Arts and Deli up on Church Street. Meeting starts at 7 o'clock. Come at 6:30 if you want to eat. The girls are at Roanoke. The girls will be at home against Roanoke Catholic on Tuesday, January the 24th. The boys will be at Halifax, and the girls will be home against Halifax on the 25th. Oh, that ball's going to be stolen, almost stolen. Paris Jamison did a good job anticipating that pass and almost was able to pick it off. A little bit of a lazy pass there. Shots up and no good. Rattles out. Bulldogs. Damian Patterson comes down with the rebound. Here he comes quickly down court. Puts up a shot. It's good. Damian Patterson. Boy, the Bulldogs have missed him. He's back in there. Hopefully he'll be able to play a lot of the ball game tonight. 12-1 Bulldogs. Pass inside, shots up, and good. Number 5 for the Warriors. He'll go to the line. Number 5 is Nick Moyer. Strong move to the basket there. Like the Warriors, going to play a lot of people. We got number 20 and number 32 checking in the game. Bronte Dickerson, he's the big kid we were telling you about. 6'6". And number 20 coming into the game is Corey Kellum. And he's a three-point shooter. I saw him in warm-ups. He was lighting it up from three-point. Three-point play for Nick Moyer. Cuts the lead to 12-4 for the Bulldogs. Bulldogs doing a nice job. We lose the ball. It's off of Magna Vista. It's going to be Bulldog basketball. Bulldogs have been able to handle the pressure real well so far. .447 to go in the first period. That ball's going to be stolen. Oh, got a travel right there. But the Warriors turn it over. Number 3 in the game for the Bulldogs. That's Brandon Adams. Kelvin Jackson's going to try to play a lot of people tonight, try to keep fresh people on the floor because the Warriors play a lot of people. Ball is knocked up in the stands. It'll be Bulldog basketball. Number 12 there, Keon Maben. Anybody that's familiar with the Magna Vista football team knows who Keon Maben is. Outstanding player for the Warriors. Had a great career over there. Paris Jamison goes up strong. Thought he was fouled, but didn't know call. Nice pass inside to Maben. He puts up a shot. And it's blocked, but a foul on Paris Jamison. So Keon's going to go to the line, and he's going to shoot 2. .12-4 Bulldogs. Shots up, no good. Nice crowd here tonight. We got a full house and very boisterous. A lot of people from both schools here tonight. It's the kind of crowd you want to see. Next shot is up and no good. Paris Jamison with the rebound. Here comes Damian Patterson down with the ball. Oh, we lose it out of bounds. 35 lost the handle there. Sharon Fuller. And so the Warriors will inbound. That's a three-pointer. It's up and no good. Rebound is tipped. Warriors come away with it. Drive to the basket, no good. Bulldogs, Patterson comes away with the ball. I tell you what, having him back in the lineup, bad pass there. 24 with the layup. Jontario Harrison, 12-6 Bulldogs. Bulldogs got to take care of the basketball now. They can't be turning it over. Nice drive, beautiful shot. Number 35 for the Bulldogs, Sharon Fuller. Strong move to the basket. Here come the Warriors. Number 10 takes a look, puts up a shot, no good. Rebound, fought for. Tip. Damian Patterson did a good job of trying to keep that ball alive, but it went off of Damian. He tried to convince the referee it was off of the Magna Vista, but the referee would have none of it. 14-6 in favor of the Bulldogs. 3:15 to go in the first quarter. Nice move. Shots up. Short. Bulldogs get the rebound. Here comes number 10 down with the ball. Puts up a shot. It's good. Great move there. Number 10, Ishmael Harrison. Strong move to the basket. 16-6. Bulldogs up by 10. 3:04 to go in the first quarter. If the Bulldogs can get a win tonight, they can move their record in the district to 3-1 and be tied for first place with the Warriors. Shots up and good. 17-6. Bulldogs are still in there. Looks like they're going to. No, Coach Jackson's telling them to back up. He's calling the press off. They're still in a man-to-man. Pass is stolen. Here comes Ishmael Harrison with the ball. He's going to go all the way. Ball slapped out of bounds by the Warriors. So it'll be Bulldog basketball. Number 30 checks back in for the Bulldogs. Jalen Dillard. Number 14, Damian Patterson's back in the game. Paris Jameson going to sit down, as will Sharon Fuller. Oh, nice play there. He tried to throw it off the Magnavis player and get the inbound pass himself. Bulldogs look real quick tonight. Shots up, and it won't go. Nice follow. Oh, good job by number 30 there to the Bulldogs. Jalen Dillon getting that offensive rebound. He just couldn't get it to fall. Oh, it's stolen by number 3. Block. Follow. Jalen Dillard. Let's see if that's going to count. People are going crazy. What was the call there? Still didn't see what it must have been, a turnover, because they did not count the points. And there's been no foul. 17-6 in favor of the Bulldogs. 2:17 to go in the first quarter. Oh, back court, not quite. Nice hustle by the Dogs. Bulldogs fight for the rebound, shots up, and good. I tell you, the Bulldogs, number 14 there, Damian Patterson, they're playing inspired basketball tonight. That quickness is giving Magna Vista a fit right now. 19-6 in favor of the Bulldogs. This game is being sponsored by the Martinsville Booster Club, and we got a foul. That'll be the third team foul against the Bulldogs. This game is sponsored. Check that, make that the fourth team foul against the Bulldogs. Sponsored by the Bulldog Booster Club. They meet every Monday night at Arts and Deli up on Church Street. Meetings are at, if you want to eat, come at 6:30. If you just want to come for the meeting, 7 o'clock. And it costs $5 to be a member. Nice three-pointer there. From number 10 for the Warriors, which is JaVale Kidd. That makes it 19-9. Bulldogs lead by 10 with 1:24 to go in the first quarter. Bulldogs, they're taking their time. They want to milk a little clock. The Warriors are in the zone, so Bulldogs be content just to hold this thing for the last shot here and have a 10-point lead at the end of the first quarter. Coach Jackson is telling them, they're starting to spread it out. Now they're going to attack. Nice inside pass. Oh, it's blocked. Beautiful block there by number 32. Bronte Dickerson with the block. Bulldogs are doing a great job to hang with the Warriors here in this first quarter, giving away a lot of height to the Warriors, but their quickness, they seem to be just a little bit quicker maybe than the Warriors right now. And that quickness is giving them trouble. Number 10, JaVale Kidd. Remember JaVale from last year? He's probably Magna Vista's best scorer, best offensive player. I believe that's his third point of the night. Shots up, and it's good. He gets that shooter's roll. The Magna Vista JVs won the first ball game tonight, 41-37, which was a tight ball game from beginning to end. Much like this ball game, a lot of quickness in that game. Remember, the JV team is coached by Doug Hankins and his son, Cricket. And they had to give up three players who moved up on the varsity because of the injury to some of the Bulldog players and some of the losses that they've incurred. Nice pass inside. Shots up, no good. Nice rebound. Put back. Jameson mistimed his jump. Jumped a little bit too quick. 23 seconds to go. Shots up, no good, rebounded. Bulldogs ought to play for one shot. Got 16 seconds. Damian Patterson takes it all the way in. 13 seconds to go. Damian should go to the line and shoot two. First time I've seen Damian. Damian didn't play last week in the Patrick County game, and Bulldogs are a much, much better basketball team when he's on the floor. No question about that. Shots up and no good. Got to make those free throws. Coach Jackson shouting instructions to the Bulldogs. I'm sure he's tickled to be up 8 points at this juncture of the first quarter. Shots up, no good, misses them both. Now the Warriors have a chance to take the last shot. 9 seconds to go. Bulldogs doing a little pressing. 3 seconds, three-pointers up, no good. Rebounded by Paris Jameson. That's the end of the first quarter. The score, the Martinsville Bulldogs, 19. The Magna Vista Warriors, 11.
The Martinsville Bulldog Boosters. Join the Martinsville Bulldog Boosters and be a part of all the athletic programs at Martinsville High School. Meetings are held on Mondays at Arts and Deli at 43rd East Church Street in Martinsville, in Uptown Martinsville, during the evenings. Enjoy great food and fellowship with Bulldogs fans and coaches, and then starting at 6 o'clock, but the meetings themselves start at 7. Annual membership dues are only $5. For more information, contact Tim Bird at 638-2727 or email at birds85@comcast.net.
On the camera tonight, we have Kara Hicks out of Mike Evans' TV production class. So she's doing all the video for us tonight. Mike Evans' class does a great job of producing all these videos, football games, basketball games, wrestling, baseball, whatever it is. His class is in charge of getting it ready to go on cable 22 TV. Good to see the stands full tonight. It usually is when you play in Magna Vista, some of the big-time rivals, but it makes for a much more exciting game when you have the bleachers full. The kids get excited, they play harder, and it just makes for a lot of excitement. And it's good to see that. Also, athletic director for the Bulldogs, Tommy Golden, and our principal, Aji Dixon. Doing a super job in his first year at Martinsville High School. Pass inside, smacked away, but the Warriors come away with it. Looking for somebody to pass it to. Pass back inside. Shots up, no good. Got a foul. Looks like it's going to go the other way. Push off under the basket by the Warriors. So the Bulldogs will inbound. Looks like the Warriors want to press a little bit here. Warriors in a man-to-man now. They've changed up. Putting some pressure on the ball. Got a timeout. Coach Jackson calls a timeout. 30-second timeout. So the Bulldogs, he wants to talk over the fact that the Warriors have gone from a zone to a man-to-man. So he wants to set up a different offense to attack this man-to-man defense that the Warriors have put out there. Next home district game for the Bulldogs will be on January the 31st. That's a Tuesday. And the boys will be taking on the Tunstall Trojans, and the girls will be at Tunstall. Also, we haven't heard a final yet, but we heard the girls are playing at Magna Vista as we speak. And the latest score we heard was the Bulldogs were up 68-57. Bulldog girls were ahead of the Warrior girls 68-57. If we get a final score, we'll give that to you as this game progresses. 19-11, 7:22 to go in the second quarter. Shots up, no good. Rebounded by Paris Jameson. And thrown, in fact, he lost it. Magna Vista threw it off of him, so I believe it'll be Magna Vista basketball. Bulldogs look like they're in a zone here. Shots up and good. Number 10, Travelle Kidd with the three. Cuts it to five, 19-14. Warriors still in a man-to-man. Paris Jameson asking for that ball down there on the blocks, but they didn't see him, couldn't give it to him. Oh, a little contact there, but no call. Here come the Warriors back down court, number five. It's Bulldog basketball. All right, here they are in the press, and the Bulldogs weren't aware of it. So Damian Patterson brings it down. She shots up, and good. Number five for the Bulldogs. Trey Harrison, a nice jumper there. 21-14 Bulldogs. Good pass inside, and the dunk by number five, Nick Boyer. Slams it home. Shots up a little strong, tipped out of bounds, and it's going to be Bulldog basketball. A lot of the Magna Vista fans underneath were not happy with that call. Looked like Paris Jameson might have tipped that out. Referees didn't have a good angle, and they call it Bulldog basketball. Whoa, ball's out of bounds. It's going to still be Bulldog basketball. The Magna Vista coaches are getting excited over on the sideline. Bulldogs will inbound under their basket. A little pick and roll there. Get that ball inside to Paris. Nice. Oh, in and out. I thought that was in. That was halfway down. Here comes Magna Vista back up court quickly. Pass inside. Good job by the Bulldogs. They're doing a great job on the ball. Nice pass. Whoa. Number three for the Bulldogs. Brandon Adams. 15 fouls for the Bulldogs, 14 fouls for the Warriors. Well, Brandon was not in the act of shooting, so the Bulldogs will inbound with 5:48 to go. Damian Patterson going to sit down. He's nursing a sprained ankle, so they got to try to get him some rest whenever they can. Bulldogs get the ball inbounds. They set up their offense. McDavis is still in a man-to-man. Nice pass inside. Nice move. Paris Jameson with his first 2 points. 23-16 Bulldogs. This is going to be a dog fight to the very end. I can tell you that. Got a foul there. I believe that's on Paris Jameson. We'll see. Yep, that's his second. And that's the team's sixth. So the Warriors will inbound under their basket. Got a man open inside. There it is. Oh, it went off his foot. 32, the big man. He was going to bounce it. He should have just took it up strong. He should have took that one up strong. He tried to dribble it off his foot. Here the Warriors in a full court press. Bulldogs beat the press. Number 10, Ishmael Harrison with the ball. Damian Patterson with the ball. Bulldogs going to slow it down a little bit. Nice move. Oh, he got him with the body. Number 32. He had it blocked, but the body got him. So number 14, Damian Patterson is going to go to the line, and that's a good job. That's what the Bulldogs have got to do. They got to challenge these guys inside and try to get them in foul trouble if they can. Shots up and no good. Damian is having a hard time from the free throw line. Missed, I think that's the third foul shot that he's missed. And the Bulldogs are going to win tonight. They need to make their foul shots. You lose a game by, you know, 2 or 3 points, and you look back and you miss 5, 6, 7 free throws, you can see how much it costs you. Missed the second one there, so here come the Warriors. They throw it away. No, they don't. They save it. Good hustle there by number 10 of the Warriors. JaVale Kidd. JaVale Kidd shoots. No good. Rebound the Bulldogs. Come off with it. Number 35 for the Bulldogs. Sharon Fuller. Bulldogs are doing a good job of beating the Warriors to the ball. I know Coach Jackson is pleased with how the Bulldogs have played thus far. .429 to go. Bulldogs have slowed it down a little bit now. Look like they might be in 2XX. Got a foul. That foul is on number 20. Corey Kellum. So I think that's the sixth team foul against the Warriors. It is. Six on both teams. I tell you, it's hard to referee a game like this. You got this much quickness. You got two teams that are as quick as these guys. Stolen by the Warriors, number 5 there. Nice rebound. Stick back is good by number 10 for the Warriors. JaVale Kidd. JaVale is asserting himself now. Nick Moyer with the steal. Shots up and good. Number 10, Ishmael Harrison. The Bulldogs can continue to hit those. They're going to stay in this ball game. 3:40 to go. The second quarter, almost stolen by the Bulldogs. Pass back to the free throw line underneath. Ball goes out of bounds off the Warriors Bulldog basketball. Paris Jameson back in the ball game for the Bulldogs. And Paris is going to bring it over midcourt, and he'll set up the Bulldog offense. Oh, it's stolen by the Warriors. Good pass. Number 10, JaVale Kidd, 26-20. Turnovers hurt you. You need to pass the ball, too much dribbling. That's going to be stolen. Here comes your dunk by number 10, JaVale Kidd. Warriors cut it to 4, 26-22. As if you didn't think they weren't going to get back in it. You knew that it was just a matter of time that they would get back in this ball game. This is going to be a hard-fought ball game right here to the bitter end. Preview of some upcoming events of the wrestling team. We'll be at Brookville this Saturday, the 21st. The Booster Club will be meeting Monday, the 23rd, at Arts and Deli up on Church Street. If you want to eat, be there at 6:30. If not, the meeting starts at 7. $5 to be a member. All money that's raised by the Booster Club goes to support athletics at Martinsville High School. Then on Tuesday, January the 24th, the girls will be at home against Roanoke Catholic. Girls are doing a good job. They are gotten a whole lot better this year. Very competitive. Then the boys on January the 25th will be at Halifax. The girls will be at home against Halifax. The 27th, the wrestling team will be at William Byrd, and the swimming team will have a quad meet at home. Boys basketball will be at Patrick County. The girls basketball will be at home. Oh, nice move. Good putback. Number 30. For the Bulldogs, Jalen Dillard with a nice stick back. Good offensive rebound, good stick back. 2:24 to go. Ball is blocked by the Bulldogs. Nice pass. Shots up and good. Number 5, Trey Harrison for the Bulldogs. Warriors call a quick timeout. 30-22 in favor of the Bulldogs. As I said, Bulldogs are 2-1 in district play. Warriors are 3-0. So a victory in tonight's ball game would tie the Bulldogs for first place at 3-1. Of course, Bassett will probably also be 3-1. So that's going to be a fight for that top spot between the Bengals, the Bulldogs, and the Warriors. As I said, we have a great, great crowd here tonight. We're about 95% packed. And kids are excited. A lot of school spirit on both sides. 2:08 to go. Bulldogs lead by 8. JaVale Kidd with the ball. He passes inside. And they put it on the floor. The ball is smacked away. I tell you, these kids are so quick on both sides. If you put the ball on the floor, it's more than likely, there's a good chance it's going to get slapped away from him. There it goes. It's a very physical game. The referees are letting him play. Paris Jamison takes it to the hoop. Nice shot. Half hook by Paris Jamison. 32-22 Bulldogs. .131 to go in the first quarter. Shot is up way up there in the air. Bulldogs going to get that rebound. Here comes number 5 quickly. And the Bulldogs are in a big hurry with the ball. And I think Coach Jackson would like to see the Bulldogs kind of slow it down, because I'm sure he would be tickled to death to go in at halftime with a 10-point lead. Bulldogs lead 32-22. With a minute and 15 seconds to go here in the first half. Bulldogs, as I said, are coached by Kelvin Jackson. He's assisted by Maquel Gravely and Larry Harrison and Javon Williamson, who played on a couple of state championship teams here in the early 2000, 2001, 2002. statistician is Tony Jeter. Our athletic director, Tommy Golden. Our principal is Aji Dixon. Assistant principal is Earl Flynn. And, of course, Connie Holland does a great job of helping to direct these basketball games. The Warriors are coached by head coach Kelvin Jackson, assisted by Corey Reynolds, Mervin Brown, and Clay Henson. Danny Morris, or is that Donnie Morris and Matthew Brown are the junior varsity coaches for the Warriors. Doug Hankins and Cricket Hankins are the JV coaches for the Bulldogs. And here come the Warriors quickly in the front court. Drive to the basket, foul there. That's going to be on number 30, Jalen Dillard. And I don't know how many fouls that is on Jalen. Let's see. They'll post it here in just a minute. That's his second. That's the team's seventh. He'll shoot two because he was in the act. Number 24, John Terrio Harrison. .32-23, 107. Shots up, tipped away, and it's off the Bulldogs, off number 30, Jalen Dillard. So the Warriors will put it in bounds, under their basket, trailing 32-23. All the Marshall coaches are standing up over there. Warriors trying to get the ball inside. 104 to go. The Warriors are going to look for a good shot. I think it would be a good idea to get that ball in JaVale Kidd's hands. Nice pass, but it's stolen by the Bulldogs. Here they come, Damian Patterson. They need to back it out, take some time, 44 seconds. We'll take a 11-point lead, maybe a 12-point lead if we can hit a three. That's a shot. It's up. No good. Oh, it's stolen by the Bulldogs again. 23 seconds to go. Rotation. Coach is calling for rotation. He wants them to play for one shot. Oh, that ball is tipped away, and it's going to be Warrior basketball. 13 seconds to go. 32-23 in favor of the Bulldogs. It's an exciting game, right? I see Charlie Holland is just shown up, so the girls must have finished their game. Hopefully they'll have a score. Last score we had, the Lady Bulldogs were up by 11 points over the Warriors, which would be a big win for them. Pass inside. Tip. Three-point shot is up, and good. And that is the first half. The score, the Bulldogs 32, the Warriors 26.
That's good. That's it for one half. We'll start up as soon as they blow the horn for the second half.
Yeah.
Martinsville Bulldog Boosters. Join the Martinsville Bulldog Boosters and be a part of all the athletic programs at Martinsville High School. Meetings are held on Mondays at Arts and Deli at 43rd East Church Street in Martinsville, in Uptown Martinsville, during the evenings. Enjoy great food and fellowship with Bulldogs fans and coaches, and then starting at 6 o'clock, but the meetings themselves start at 7. Annual membership dues are only $5. For more information, contact Tim Bird at 638-2727 or email at birds85@comcast.net.
Okay, we're ready to start the second half here at the Doghouse. Big district game between the Magna Vista Warriors and the Martinsville Bulldogs. Bulldogs are ahead here at halftime by a score of 32-26. Bulldogs got off to a fast start, jumped ahead of the Warriors by about, I think, maybe as much as 12 points in the first quarter. The Warriors have been able to trim the lead to as little as 4, and now the Warriors trail by 6 points as we start the third quarter. Bulldogs will inbound basketball at midcourt. Looks like the Warriors going to come out in a man-to-man defense. Yep, man-to-man, and Bulldogs will set up their offense. Number 10, Ishmael Harrison with the ball. Bulldogs work the ball around the perimeter. Parrish James, a nice pass inside, and shots up, no good. Rebound tipped away, number 30 there, Jalen Dillard. Warriors are setting up their offense. Bulldogs are in a man. Looking inside, JaVale Kidd with the ball. Boy, he's had an outstanding first half for the Warriors. Shots up and no good. Rebounds up and good. Number 42 for the Warriors, Latrell Wells. Long and lanky. We got a foul on number 24, I think, the Warriors. That'll be their first. Bulldogs have one. And Damian Patterson will inbound. 32-28 in favor of the Bulldogs. Good job, number 30, coming to the basketball. Parrish James, a nice move. Can't get it to go, but he was fouled, so he'll go to the line and shoot two. I guess if there's been any Achilles heel for the Bulldogs in the first half, will be probably their free throw shooting. They've missed several opportunities at the free throw line, which could come back to bite them at the end of the ball game if this ends up in a close ball game, which I think it is. Shots up and good by Parrish James. 33-28 Bulldogs. Second shot is up, and it's good as well. Looks like the Bulldogs are going to go into a little 55 full-court press. Try to see if they can get the Warriors to turn the ball over. Warriors do a good job of getting the ball across. Ball is lost out of bounds, but it's tipped out by the Bulldogs. Warriors will inbound under their basket. Warriors passing the ball around the perimeter. Looking for an outside shot or looking for an entry pass. They get the ball inside. Number 12 has it blocked. Here come the Bulldogs. Damian Patterson with the ball. Nice move by Damian Patterson. What a move. 36-28 Bulldogs. Oh, foul. Foul on number five. Trey Harrison. That'll be the second team foul against the Bulldogs. Number 20 checking back in for the Warriors. Corey Kellum. Number 12 going to sit down. Be Keon Maven will sit down for the Warriors. I tell you, the guy that's impressed me for the Warriors tonight is number 10, JaVale Kidd, man. He's the real deal. He can score inside or outside. He has the ball right now. He puts up a three-pointer, and it's good. Nothing but net. 36-31. Oh, we got to travel. And here comes Coach Jackson down. I don't think he liked that call. Or maybe he just wants to talk to one of his players there. 5:57 to go in the third. Warriors trail. Cross-court pass. Ball reaching foul there. That's going to be on number 10, Ish Harrison. That's going to be the second team foul against the Bulldogs. So the Warriors were not in the act of shooting, so they'll inbound under their basket. Warriors set their offense. Bulldogs back in a little bit, 2-3 zone. 2-3 zone now. They're out of the man-to-man. See how that were. Ball is tipped. Great job. Good hustle by Paris Jameson. Damian Patterson gets the ball. Nice move. Puts the shot up. No good. Tip, no good. Rebounded by the Warriors. Number five, Nick Moyer. Oh, we got a foul. Third team foul against the Bulldogs. Ball's up and no good. Rebounded by the Bulldogs. Number 10, Ishmael Harrison. Strong on the boards. In spite of the height advantage that the Warriors have, Bulldogs have done a good job on the offense and defensive board. Shots up, no good. Rebounded by number 32, Bronte Dickerson. Big 6'6". Looking inside, Bronte wants the ball. Three-point shot is good. Number 20, Corey Kellum with the three. 36-34. Bulldogs by two. Thought we were going to take a three right there, but Ishmael thought better of it. He looking for some help. Almost loses it. Got to be a push right there, yep. Number 10, JaVale Kidd, who's having an outstanding offensive game tonight. That's his first. Bulldogs by two. Ball smacked out of bounds by number five, Nick Moyer for the Warriors. The Warriors have come out here and quickly erased a 9-point lead. And it's down to two now. Pass underneath. Blocked. 32, Bronte Dickerson comes away with the rebound. Shots up, and it is no good. Ball's fought for. It's going to be Magna Vista ball. Kevin Johnson talking to his team over there. Ball is inbounded to 32, Dickerson. Another three-point. Oh, that could have been a foul right there. Shots up, no good. Rebounded. Number five is Nick Moyer doing a great job on the offensive board for the Warriors. I tell you, we fouled that three-point shot right there. We lucky it didn't get caught. It's good. Number 24. Got Terry O. Hairston with the three. Puts the Warriors up by one. Got a timeout. Warriors are excited. Their first time they've led tonight. 37-36. 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go.
The Martinsville Bulldog Boosters. Join the Martinsville Bulldog Boosters and be a part of all the athletic programs at Martinsville High School. Meetings are held on Mondays at Arts and Deli at 43rd East Church Street in Martinsville, in Uptown Martinsville, during the evenings. Enjoy great food and fellowship with Bulldogs fans and coaches, and then starting at 6 o'clock, but the meetings themselves start at 7. Annual membership dues are only $5. For more information, contact Tim Bird at 638-2727 or email at birds85@comcast.net.
In the third quarter, reminder that this game is sponsored by the Martinsville Booster Club. They meet every Monday night at Arts and Deli up on Church Street. The meetings start at 6:30 if you want to eat, 7 o'clock if you just want to come. To hear the coaches, they will be there. The JV and varsity coaches will be there, and they will give you a coach's report. We'll talk about the ball game they just played, as well as any upcoming games that they have. And that's Monday, January 23rd at Arts and Deli, 6:30. Girls basketball, Roanoke Catholic at home on the January the 24th, which is Tuesday. Then on the 25th, the boys will be at Halifax. The girls will be here against Halifax. Wrestlers will on the 27th will be at William Byrd, and the swim team will be at home with a quad meet. Boys basketball will be at Patrick Kennedy. The girls will be here on the January the 27th. Almost smacked away. Paris Jameson takes it to the hoop. Ball is blocked. Shots up, blocked again. Number 32 there. Bronte Dickerson, 6'6". Making it tough on the Bulldogs to get a shot off close to the basket. Oh, the ball smacked away. We're lucky to get that one back. Damian Patterson's going to inbound now for the Bulldogs. Bulldogs looking for a shot. Ishmael turns down a shot, shots up, no good. Fall for Paris Jameson. Great offensive rebound by Paris and stick back. 38-37 Bulldog. Got a foul on the floor. That's going to be the fourth team foul against the Bulldogs. Warriors have four. So the Warriors are going to inbound under their basket. 38-37 in favor of the Bulldogs. Couldn't ask for a better game than this. Can't leave him alone. He traveled. I tell you what, you cannot leave him alone. Number 20 there for the Warriors. That's Corey Kellum. He can knock down the threes. The Bulldogs inbound with a one-point lead, 3 minutes and 8 seconds to go in the third period. Warriors in a man-to-man. Bulldogs are going to have to make some outside shots because it's going to be hard to get anything inside against these taller Warriors, especially with Dickerson in the game. Oh, nice block by Patterson. three-pointer is good. I don't need to tell you who that is. Number 10, Javrell Kidd. Shots up, no good. JaVale Kidd with the rebound, has it stolen, gets it back, and the foul is on number 3. Brandon Adams of the Bulldog. 40-38 in favor of the Warriors. Bulldogs need to keep it close. If the Warriors get a lead of about 10 points, it's going to be tough for the Bulldogs to get back into it. Warriors up by 2. Shots up, good. Number 24 for the Warriors. It's Ontario Harrison. 42-38 Warriors. Nice follow. Won't go. Yes. Good job. Nice pass. Number 30 with a basket. Jalen Dillard. Nice pass inside. Shots up. Foul. And Bronte Dickerson, big 6'6" youngster, is going to go to the line for the Warriors. He's going to shoot 2. 42-40 in favor of the Warriors. 1:44 to go in the third period. Nip and tuck. This has been a good basketball game. Shots up and good. 43-40. Magna Vista looks like to me, they got a team, because the Bulldogs and the Warriors are in two different divisions in basketball, so when they go, both of these teams will go to the playoff. But the Warriors look like they have a team that can contend, go a long way in the playoffs. I know the Bulldogs hope to do the same thing. 43-40, 1:37, shots up and good, number 5. Trey Harrison with the running jumper. Bulldogs back in their press. Oh, what we got there? Got a travel. Warriors turn it over. Damian Patterson's back in the ball game. Number 10, Ishmael Harrison gonna sit down. 35 coming back in the game for the Bulldogs. Sharon Fuller. That's it. Looks like a Warrior stealing a man-to-man. 43-42. Shots up. Good. Number 3. Brandon Adams for the Bulldogs. We'll put the score up on the wrong side. Shots up. No good. Rebounded by James and getting up there with those tall trees.